Are you thinking of skipping this attempt? Do you think your preparation is not good enough to pass this attempt? Maybe you can study harder next time. Are you stressed, unwell, heartbroken to decide? Are you scared that people are gonna laugh at you, your relatives, your family members, they'll be disappointed if you fail? It's better to skip, maybe. Well then, you've hit the right place. I'll give you reasons why you should definitely attempt. You will get in your comfort zone. If you skip this attempt, your mind will kind of cool down a little bit. You will subconsciously think that there is a lot of time left to study and that the next exam is like 6 months away. You'll take a break, you'll go for a vacation, maybe you'll watch a few movies and date someone new. Well, you'll also buy some new books, you know. You'll take some coaching and make a fresh new plan to hit this exam really well this time. You might study really well, but most likely the chances are that you will start telling yourself this lie that there is way too much time ahead and that you are ahead of everyone else who will be giving the next attempt. So you have much better chances of cracking this exam next time. You might have already studied the syllabus once. So basically you will start taking things for granted. Until it's again just 1 or 2 months left and you are in the same exact situation, where you have a mountain of course to finish and way too much stress and fear. Maybe even more than the last time, because you have added pressure of a missed attempt and because of all the time that has already passed. You will be scared of failing again, and this vicious cycle may repeat and form a really dangerous habit of staying in your comfort zone. And listen, my friend, success never happens in your comfort zone. The point is, you might not reap the benefits that you think you will reap if you miss this attempt. Your stress will maybe not reduce. And so you might as well face the situation now and learn something from it. You might lose your fire. So right now, you might be having a very burning anxiety and stress that is keeping you up at night and making you study fat books. Now you might call it fear, or stress, or a sense of emergency, or peer pressure, whatever you want. But if you skip this attempt, this is going to cool off a bit. This fire inside you will be buried deep down for some time. Either it will stay buried and make you lazy or depressed, or you will have to work really, really hard again to reignite this whole fire. But one thing is for sure, you need this fire to pass any exam. Whether it feels pleasant or not, it is this fire that motivates your actual performance. So you need to make the most of it. You need to keep it burning. And the best way to do that is to attempt this exam without attaching yourself mentally or emotionally to the result. Just try and give your best. Handle this worry. It's part of your journey. I know you're really scared that you might not pass in this exam, and you're probably so scared that you don't even want to attempt this paper. But listen to me. Let's have a reality check. This is just fear. It is in your mind. And no matter how prepared you are, no matter how many mocks you have given, how many papers of past exams that you've solved, how many times you have revised, you will always feel the same way till you actually crack this exam. And it's not bad. It's actually pretty good. It's very natural. Everybody goes through this. It tells that you actually care about this exam and you really want to crack it. This fear will stay with you till you crack this exam. So why not try to get used to it and learn to handle it? You can try praying to whichever God or universe that you believe in. You should remind yourself of those past achievements that you never thought you would be able to accomplish, but you actually did. You can talk to those people who believe in you, because you are much stronger than this. Please remember that. And this fear and worry is not just limited to your exams. It is going to stay in your life even ahead. So in a way, this exam is preparing you for life. So maybe you should try to handle it right now. You should learn to deal with it. Because if you master it now, I promise you will be successful in life, whether you pass in this attempt or in the next. You have nothing to lose. Maybe you are sure that from your level of preparation, you will surely fail, that there is just no way to pass or get the kind of marks that you want. Well then, isn't it liberating in a way? I mean, think about it. You will fail anyways, whether you attempt the exam or you don't. So basically, you have nothing to lose really. So just relax, give the attempt. Why waste another 6 months? Why not try and experiment with the exams? Maybe prepare one group fully and attempt that. Or maybe attempt both the groups without expectations. Or maybe try for an exemption in some subjects. I mean, just try something. I mean, what do you have to lose anyways? You might as well pass. Who knows? Think of the bigger picture. In the next 3 to 5 years, this situation won't be such a big deal for anyone. When you will pass someday, none of your failures will matter to anyone. Everyone will see you as a success. But what will stay with you for the rest of your whole life is your experience and the way you handled this situation. Did you shy away from it because of fear, or did you face it with the courage and learn from it? Your journey will be unique because of the choices you made. How many marks you score won't really matter in the real world, you know. But what will matter is your mental strength, your courage, your determination and focus, your ability to face the challenges and grow from them. No matter what the result will be, if you give this attempt, I promise that you will be one step closer to your goals. After all, no matter how many times you have to try at a thing, you just need to pass it one time to make it a success. So I really hope that after listening to all those reasons, you will attempt the paper. Karam kar phal ki chinta mat kar balak. And mera aashirwad tumhare saath hai. All the very best to you. And if you want to see more videos, if you really want to encourage me, and I really need encouragement, please hit that like button and share it with a couple of your friends. And subscribe to my channel and comment down below, aapko kaisa laga ye video, and what do you think, what more type of videos you want. I'll see you next time.